spécial match. How are you people? Good to see you around. My name is Uganji Bruno. I'm a video artist. I'm a visual artist and art educator, a TEDx Kampala organizer, and a lover of the people and the environment. So in 2007, I want to take you back to where all this began. In 2007, I was a student in Tsavo University. And I left my village and I come to the city to look for a paper of education, to look for more satisfaction. And all I ever wanted to be was a visual professional artist like the Picassos, like the legends we have here in Uganda, like Mugarura. Then we were in class and we were given an assignment. The assignment was, can you find a community problem and solve it with your art? So I looked around, not familiar with city life. You know, waste is a big problem that we have even here in Kampala, just like any other city in the world. The bottles were rampant, and I made a hand as a prototype, which I shared with my friends in class. And the hand was stretched out like this. This hand was supposed to be made using photos, but to give a message to the public that we use the hand to throw rubbish and bottles in the environment, but we can use the same hand to pick the bottles so as to conserve our environment. So we set out to look for people who are interested in our ideas. And I met a gentleman who works with UNICEF. He's called Gwenja Edward, and he gave us his compound because there's no public space where you can put such kind of art. So as a group, we went out. Collecting these bottles is not a problem. We were able to raise over 20,370 bottles that we used to build the giant hand, the hand that speaks. From there, from the teamwork, from the connection, from how the environment was getting satisfied, and how the community were always referring to us as bottle artists, I realized that I could not go back, finish a university degree, and start looking for a job. I had done a lot of paintings before I was selling, but it wasn't making much satisfaction to my heart. Because this is where the community comes in and says, hey, we like what you do. Yes, we can support you in any way that you want, but keep up the good work. So we started EcoArt. And with EcoArt Uganda, we are a group of 14 visual artists. We are all from university fresh, without employment, and on the streets of Kampala. So we say our message needs to communicate to people. We have to find out where they are. So we started going to street art festivals, like this is Uganda Festival in 2010. We built a giant map of Uganda with the bottles, but we didn't do it ourselves as we. We encouraged the community, the people around, to build it with us. So they have to collect the bottles, they have to participate in the construction because they want to see the finished work. In my works, it's about interactive. You don't need to be an artist to do it, as long as the idea is sat in your head. So in 2011, I was invited at the Street Art Festival to present my artwork. And we did as well an interactive project with the audience. And people loved it. So I kept sharing pictures. It's good to use social network, you people. I was on Facebook, And a lady that I've never met who just liked my work, she's called Monica Ainov. And she's like, do you know about TED? You should share your idea on TED. Do you have a TEDx in your camp, in your Kampala in Uganda? I said, what? Who is TED? Just like everyone else when we are invited. Well, TEDx, okay. The place or person. Then she sent me a link to the website. So I went on, and there was actually so much of sharing. So much of sharing that was going on. I said, I think this is what I always wanted to do. We had made over 10 projects, but we had never known that there was TED. So I became the first organizer of TEDx Kampala, and in 2012 I had my first event, and I was invited to the TEDx Summit in Qatar. It was the first time as well to fly out, but well, it was a good experience to meet so many people and share with them what we are doing on the ground. So actually at the event, I mobilized because I'm always interested with people and sharing about recycling. So we met the TEDx with some of the organizers, and it's going to be used on the website to present more about recycling. So I pitched my idea in the City 2.0. What is City 2.0? It's a place where people who are innovators, the people who have ideas that can change the city, can pitch in an idea. And if they like it, and if the crowd supports it, you'll find it. So I was on stage. I was on stage with five more people who had come to pitch in their ideas. And all we had to do was to show what we wanted to do. And my idea was to create an eco-art amusement park with the children. So we went out and shared the story, and I went on stage that day and I won the City 2.0 award to create an amusement park for children living in slums in Kampala. Having gotten the award, I went down on the ground. We have so many slums, you know. You cannot build every slum an amusement park in one day. So I had to start out and say, what do I do? Look at my community around me, and I figured out that Acholi Quarters was actually near Chambok University, where I'm teaching in the Department of Art and Industrial Design. So I met the local leadership, the chairman, they welcomed the idea. And all we did was to share the dream and passion to create the amusement park. The parents were invited to the school. The children knew what it was going to be, a place to play, which they never had in the first place. So they went out and started collecting bottles. They collected the bottles, then we started filling in the soil, because I had in mind to create some 3D games that can ease learning, that can make learning much more fun than it is in our classic schools. So with that, we managed to raise 3,070 something bottles, which were used, like you see, to build the wall, build the snakes and ladders game, build a game that would change mathematics, English, whatever subject it is. A teacher always has to make the questions, then sits around with the students and they can answer as they play to make it more interactive and enjoying. With that, I see the world open to us, and I'm glad to share my story that a community that you are in is much more powerful when a brilliant idea is born. And this is what we've done. At the moment, we are almost done, and I will invite you, all you guys, at the launch of the amusement park in Kampala. This is what I'm doing for my city. What are you doing? Thank you for listening.